Hi everyone, in this video I'm going to walk you through the process I followed to recreate this image you see in the left side, which is the original photo, and this is what I created mainly in vectors. I also used some bitmaps, but mainly in vectors. So this is a walkthrough video more than a tutorial per se, and I'm gonna show you how to go about this. Okay, let's start. So the first thing I did is selecting this image that I found. I'm gonna show you in this website. It's called Unsplash, and it's full of super nice pictures that you can use for your personal or commercial projects. I'm gonna credit the author. It's Vincent Guth, and he took this picture somewhere in Finland. And he's got his portfolio here with different images you can just use, as I just said. And I copy-pasted it into Affinity Designer and I started working, looking at every aspect of the image and trying to understand how I could just recreate something similar. If you see here, for example, we have a background that goes from this purple to some lighter here purple, like dark purple, mid purple, and at the very bottom, and because it's the background, I'm gonna want to have some kind of like a dark black color. So I'm gonna show you here, come to my layers, and I select the background. I'm gonna isolate it in a new canvas so you can see basically what it has, which is a gradient that goes, as I said, from some grayish purple to a more saturated purple. And then black. This black is going to blend with the forest, with the trees that are completely black. Okay, so that is for the background. On top of this, I'm gonna lock it. On top of this, I have some lights. I'm gonna make them invisible. So you see that right now we just see the background, the beams that I will explain a little bit later, and the lights. I'm gonna open this group. And you're gonna see what kind of shapes I created for this. As you can see, they are kind of like crazy shapes that are just functioning for me in such a way that they give me exactly the colors, the amount of colors we see in the original, which is this kind of like little bit of green here, a little bit of purple here, a little bit of blue. So that's basically what I've done. Stacking lots of different shapes and giving them different colors, following my reference, of course. And then I applied a really, really strong Gaussian blur to them, so they look really blurry, and so you cannot see the edges, and they blend together really well. That's for the lights in the sky. Then we have the beams, which are these ones in here, which basically follow the same procedure. I create, let's select just, for example, this one. So I create this crazy shape in here, give it a big amount of Gaussian blur. This time is 44, 45 almost. And the next one has 21, because as you can see in here, these beams have like a glow, but also like a central part that is that needs a little bit less of Gaussian blur. Let's go back to the let's go back to the original. So in order to create this, we create a shape. Could be created with something as simple as this one. Shape, give it an angle, give it a color close to white, but not completely white, something like that. And now we go to the effects, select it, and give it a Gaussian blur like this, something like this. Okay, so that's basically the procedure to create these beams. Now, now if I want to make something a little bit less blurry, to create this effect. And here I'm gonna just reduce the Gaussian in here like that. And yeah, it looks like a shape that has a glow applied to it, but it's not a glow that I apply through the effects panel, because in this way I have more control over the looks of it. So I always say, yeah, this is fantastic and you can use it in so many ways, but sometimes it's worth to just create things yourself, and instead of just creating the shape and then giving it a glow, it's better to just stack two different shapes and give them the properties and effects you need for them. Okay, so that's for the beams, and now let's go with the trees. So we go to the layers panel, let's collapse this and let's look for the trees that are in the top, is the top group in my artwork. And as you can see in here, well, down in the bottom I have this shape, which as you can see, well, it has this curve in here, so it just follows a little bit what I needed. As you can see, it also has this little amount of Gaussian blur, and that's because instead of making it look, even though you cannot really appreciate it very well, details are important. So you don't want to have a sharp shape for the ground, even though it's kind of like, you know, you cannot really perceive it. It's just much better to give it a little bit, even a small amount of Gaussian blur to every shape in this kind of organic graphic. So that's what I did. And now the trees, most of them are images, as you can see in the layers panel. There's a reason for that, and it's the fact that Affinity Designer as of today doesn't have a tracing tool. So either you use a third-party tool to trace your trees, or you do them by hand, which, you know, with the, you know, the amount of effects, and it's so intricate that I wouldn't recommend to do this by hand unless you have lots of patience and time. So what I've done in here is just taking images. I'm gonna show you what I did exactly. So I came to a website like Unsplash, Pixabay, and I looked for a pine tree, and I found this one, for example, which I really like, and it has transparent background, which is just what we need. It's perfect. I copy it and come back to Affinity Designer, create a new canvas, and I paste it there. Okay, I'm gonna make it a little bit smaller so it fits. And it's as simple as this. I come to effects, I give it a color overlay, and because, even though you see here white canvas, because as you can see here, the image has no background, it's just ready to go. You come here now, come to your image, paste it. It's quite big, this image I created. Sorry. Like this, and it's ready to go. You just place it somewhere that fits, and there you go, you have it. So most of these trees are created that way, looking for some nice pictures where I could just apply this color overlay in black, and that's the mystery of it. There's another one, this one, for example. This one, it says curves, it's because it's all vectors. See how crazy it is? Well, I don't know if I had this one in my assets, because I have lots of assets, ready-made assets, but I mean, it's not very convenient to have something like this. It's just crazy. So, I mean, even though you can reduce the amount of nodes, the procedure to create this as of today, not having a tracing tool in here, it's just not worth. So I just put this one in here to show you, but for the rest I simply use images, nice trees I found on the internet. I just gave them this color overlay. If it's possible, use a tree that has no background. If you find one with a background, you're gonna have to get rid of it. For that, well, you can do it in Affinity Designer, in Affinity Photo, in Photoshop, whatever you want. So That's basically it for the trees. Now, the last element in this artwork is the stars. You see in here, so what I've done is creating, stacking two groups of lots of little double stars. So basically, as you can see in there, I picked this double star tool in this combo here. I dragged in here with a white color, probably, yeah, it has some opacity, 30%, not to make them too prominent, and you know, they would look a little bit unreal. So what I've done is just copy paste, copy paste, copy paste very many times, just one time like this. Then I duplicate the group of them. Probably I'm gonna flip them so they don't look exactly the same. I'm gonna give them a different angle, and so in this way you just go adding and adding more and more stars, as many as you want. Let's just exaggerate it a little bit. I'm gonna copy these two. See, now you can see many more in there. Let's just go like this, and maybe now what we want to do is give them, where is the handler? Yeah, here. So give them a little bit of an angle so it looks more like natural, more organic, you know. And that's basically it. So you can see, going back to both of them, it looks kind of similar. I think it's pretty decent. And the whole mystery of this is just looking at it and thinking, what do I have in my tools that will allow me to get here? And just little by little you craft it, and you're gonna have something, you know, pretty similar and quite nice. So I hope you like this walkthrough video. Sorry, I am a little bit busy lately, so maybe I'm not doing videos every week. I'm trying, but sometimes it's not possible. Anyways, if you like it, please comment, like, subscribe, and I don't know, send me a kiss or something. See you soon. Bye-bye.